Danny Holland's off, and Conor Chaplin comes on. Great moment for the lad, and Nigel Atangana will come on for Lee Holmes. Wallace to Tubbs. Atangana has it on the right hand side, tries to thread it through for Tubbs. Still Tubbs has it, edge of the D, releases Chaplin. Here's a chance, left footed shot, and it's a goal! And Conor Chaplin has got his first professional goal, and he's got Pompey right back in it. It's Morecambe 2, Pompey 1. Again, dancing to the dead ball line, across flashes it. Well, Chaplin cleared off the line.
Yeah, it was cleared off the line, and I think it was John McComb, I think.
Feels it's own ball. I think he might have a case.
McComb clearing off the line with his forearm as Chaplin drove it from about 6 yards out as Wallace flashes across the goal mouth and poked away by Alechnik straight to Chaplin.
And as we said goodbye to 2014-15, Conor Chaplin was about to know what it felt like to become a Pompey poster boy.
Holland's down the line for Stevens. Stevens cuts it back! And Portsmouth take the lead for a second time. Chaplin with the goal. A teenager on the score sheet and he's absolutely ecstatic.
Never scored at Fratton before in my life. Literally never in a training game, nothing. That's my first ever goal at Fratton. And yeah, I think I've said it before in an interview, but that tops it out as my best feeling. In front of these fans, obviously, I've grown up a Pompey fan and a Pompey player all my life, and I've been in that stand just over there watching it for 6-7 years, and to score and to see the elation of the fans, just you can't want anything more than that.
Word for Chaplin, he'll pursue and it will go straight through to Hansi. Conor Chaplin, can he profit? It's up against the goalkeeper, around the goalkeeper he goes. Conor Chaplin finds it! Conor Chaplin makes El Hansi wish he were not here at Fratton tonight. And it's Conor Chaplin again in the Capital One Cup, profiting from a goalkeeping gap to drive into the roof of the net.
Talk us through it, because you took a gamble there, didn't you? Sort of chasing, you know, tracking down Ali Al-Habsi, and assuming you might make a mistake, and he certainly did, and then you just did the rest.
Yeah, it's just a lost cause, really. Obviously, the ball was put in behind, it's a great ball from Dutch, and I've anticipated on a mistake, really. All you can do is chase down the ball, and they've sort of left it for each other, and it's broken to me. And I was going to lob him straight away, but I thought it was just a little bit too close to me, so I stopped and tried to compose myself and rounded him. And to be honest, when I shot, I didn't know how acute the angle was when I originally shot. The first one, I've seen the ball break through and sort of rush towards the ball, taking it in my chest, taking a touch past him or just to the side of him, and then just got a shot away on my right foot, and I've hit it across goal just like you taught, and thankfully it went through the bodies and it went across the goal, and that's where keepers can't save, really. Yeah, it's funny, the second one, me and Tubby had a conversation just before. I was like, Tubby, you come short for this one, I'll go long. So I'll just switch it up a bit. And the movement obviously worked. The kick wasn't great, it was a bit of a fluff kick, and it bounced. And a bit like the Luton goal, to be honest. But today, obviously, I scored, and I'm happy to do that.
Well done. I think we'll be saying that to you a few times this season.